Hello everyone. Today our topic is the spiral model. Spiral model is one of the most important software development lifecycle models which provides support for risk handling. The spiral model combines the idea of iterative development with the systematic controlled aspects of the waterfall model. It allows increment releases of the product or incremental refinement through each iteration around the spiral. So spiral model emphasizes on risk analysis. The exact number of loops of the spiral is unknown and can vary from project to project. Each loop of the spiral is called a phase of software development process. The exact number of phases needed to develop the product can be varied by the project manager depending upon the project risks. The spiral model has four phases: planning, design, construct or build, and evaluation and risk analysis. A software project repeatedly passes through these phases in iterations called spirals in this model. Planning phase starts with the gathering of business requirements. In the subsequent spirals, as the product matures, identification of system requirements and unit requirements are done in this phase. This also includes understanding of system requirements by continual communication between the customer and the analyst. At the end of the spiral, the product is deployed. Design phase starts with the design in the baseline spiral and involves architectural, logical design of modules, physical product design, and final design in the successive spirals. Construct phase refers to development of the final software product at every spiral. In the spiral, when the product is just thought and the design is being developed, a proof of concept, POC, is developed in this phase to get the user's feedback. Then in the successive spirals, with their clarity on requirements and design, a working model of the software called BERT is developed with a version number. These versions are sent to the users for feedback. Risk analysis includes identifying, estimating, and monitoring the technical feasibility and management risks, such as casual slippage and cost overrun. After testing the BERT, at the end of the first iteration, the customer evaluates the software and provides feedback. Next, applications of the spiral model. The spiral model is widely used in the software industry as it is in sync with natural development process of any product, i.e. learning with maturity, which involves minimum risk for the customer as well as the development company. It's also suitable for medium to high risk projects if the customers are not sure of their requirements, which is usually the case. It's also applicable when significant changes are expected in the product during the development cycle, when there is a budget constraint and risk evaluation is important. New product line should be released in phases to get enough customer feedback, and long-term project commitment because of potential changes to economic priorities as the requirements change with time. The main advantages of the spiral model are: it allows elements of the product to be added in when they are become available or known. This assures that there is no conflict with the previous requirements and design. It's good for large and complex projects. In this model, requirements can be captured more accurately. Development can be divided into smaller parts, and the risk parts can be developed earlier, which helps in better risk management. Changing requirements can be accommodated. Customers can see the development of the product at the early phase of the software development. And the spiral model allows extensive use of prototypes. However, the spiral model has the following disadvantages. Management is more complex, not suitable for small projects, and in most cases, it's an expensive model. As the number of phases are unknown at the start of the project, time estimation is very difficult, so the end of the project may not be known early. The spiral may go on indefinitely. A large number of intermediate stages requires excessive documentation. For today, that's all. Thank you.